Today, we are going to talk about how to add custom colors in Tailwind CSS version 4. Tailwind already offers a great color palette. For example, classes like Text Blue 500 and BG Green 700, you can do almost anything. But why would you want to add your own colors? Let's say you are building a website for a coffee shop and need that exact shade of brown, which doesn't exist in Tailwind by default. Or maybe you are working with a tech brand that requires a very specific blue. Designers sometimes say, "I want this exact color." In such cases, Tailwind's default colors might not be enough, and adding custom colors becomes necessary to fully personalize the project. One of the newest features in Tailwind CSS version 4 is the CSS-first approach. What does that mean? It means no more fiddling with configuration files. You can now do everything directly within your CSS. In the past, we had to deal with JavaScript configuration files. Now, everything is faster and simpler. For instance, if you want to add a custom color, you just write it in your CSS file, that's it. This approach speeds up your workflow and gives you incredible flexibility. So, how did we do it before? In previous versions, to customize Tailwind, we used the tailwind config.js file. This is where we defined colors, spacing, font sizes, and all other settings. But now we can handle all of this through CSS variables. In Tailwind CSS version 3 and earlier, creating a custom color or theme required JavaScript configuration. For example, if we wanted to add a color in the tailwind config.js file, we would define it under colors and manually specify the values. Let's say we defined ocean blue and assigned it a hex code. Then we might add ocean light and ocean dark for variations. After making changes, we had to recompile Tailwind, which took more time with each edit. Now we no longer need to mess with JavaScript files. We can define everything directly in CSS. For example, in our style.css file, we import Tailwind CSS and use the theme directive. Let's say we want to add a sunset theme. We write something like color sunset orange and assign it a hex value. Then we can add more variations underneath if we want. This method is a great example of the CSS-first approach. That means you can now manage your colors, fonts, and other customizations directly through CSS, instead of relying on JavaScript files. So, we have defined our custom colors. How do we use them? Let's close that window and jump into a quick example. You can also visit play.tailwindcss.com and try this without installing anything. On that site, I have my CSS tab on one side and the HTML tab on the other side. I will write the HTML code here, and on the CSS side, we will see the changes live. As an example, let's build a button. We will give it a class to apply our custom color. In the past, we would just write something like background red 500 and that would apply the color. But now, there is a small but important detail. We can't just write the class name as is. Instead, we have to use square brackets to refer to a CSS variable. Let's say we want a custom button color for a brand. Tailwind might not have an exact color we need in its palette. So, instead, we define a custom blue using the theme directive and assign it in CSS. Once it's defined, we can use it in our HTML. We start by removing the old class and writing BG var brand blue. Tailwind recognizes this and applies the custom color. This brand blue isn't part of Tailwind's built-in color system. It's one we have defined ourselves. But using this method, we can add any shade we want and apply it just like any other Tailwind class. Since Tailwind is a utility-first framework, it normally generates static classes like BG red, text gray, etc. But if we are using dynamic CSS variables, Tailwind needs the value to be inside square brackets to process it correctly. So, in short, if you are using built-in Tailwind colors, you can use classes like BG red 500 directly. So if you are using a static color like BG red 500, you just write it as is. But if you are working with a variable like brand blue, the proper format is BG var brand blue. And custom colors aren't limited to just backgrounds or text. You can use them for borders, shadows, button effects, and more. You already know what Tailwind CSS is and how it works. At this point, you are capable of adapting it to your own projects. For example, let's say you want to use a yellow tone for a border. First, go to your CSS file and define the color. Then switch to the HTML section and apply it using border classes. When you add the yellow color, it works just fine. But remember, when adding a border in Tailwind, you also need to define its thickness. You can use classes like border, border 2, or border 4 to control that. For example, if I use border B4, it only applies the border to the bottom. If I want to add a shadow using the same custom color, I simply add the shadow utility and specify the value I want. Top, right, left, and bottom. Then switch to using the CSS variable. Inside parentheses, I write something like var dark blue. This gives us a shadow that's 0 pixels from the top, 4 pixels from the left and right, and 10 pixels from the bottom in the dark blue color. You can use these custom colors not only as border colors, but also as shadow effects, or in any other way that suits your visual design. It's all up to how you want to use them. We have learned how to define and apply custom colors, but if you want to use them more systematically, you can build a structure similar to Tailwind's native color system. For example, Tailwind has predefined color levels like green 100, green 300, green 500, etc. Let's replicate that same system with our custom green tones. First, we go to the CSS file and define green shades like Brent Green 100, Brent Green 300, Brent Green 500, and so on. Then we switch to the HTML site and write classes like BG var Brent Green 500. I wrote a basic background just as a placeholder so you can see it in action. But instead of hard coding the color name, we are using the variable inside square brackets with the var function. That way, when we write 500 at the end, it automatically picks up the correct shade. That's the idea. We assign a label and Tailwind reads the value behind that label. So if I write green 100, it pulls the value we defined for Brent Green 100. This makes it easy to keep consistent color theming across your project. And of course, you can tailor these values to fit your brand's identity. It gives you a lot more flexibility and makes your design process smoother. As soon as I type 300, 500, or 700, I instantly see the changes reflected in the preview. Now, if I want to apply this not as a background, but as text color, I can simply copy the same logic and change BG to text. The concept is exactly the same. We are just applying it to a different property. So, instead of BG var Brent Green 700, text var Brent Green 700, and it applies to the text. If I wanted a lighter tone, I could have used 300 or even 500, all of which I have already defined in the CSS file. I'll go back and make it a background again. And while I'm at it, let's add a border as well. I just copy the same part and change BG to border. It's the same idea. Don't let it confuse you. I'm doing the same process step by step. So now we are effectively using both Brent Green 300 and Brent Green 700. To wrap things up, in this video we have shown how you can manage your entire color system directly from your style CSS file without ever touching Tailwind config.js. This gives you a much more flexible and streamlined way to work with custom colors, while still mimicking the structure and convenience of Tailwind's default color system. Everything now runs through your CSS file, and that means faster workflows, more visual clarity, and easier theming overall. That's it for this video. I hope it was useful. See you in the next one.